Hi, welcome to the statics tutorials. In this problem, we have a mass of 100 kilograms, which is supported by three cables. We have AB, which is going up to the ceiling. We have AC, which is going up to the ceiling. And we have AD, which connects between this ring and the 100 kilogram mass here. You can see the dimensions that we have over here. We have a 3 meter drop from the ceiling down to point A. And we have 4 meters over from point C to point A. Over here on AB, we don't have the dimensions, but we do have that there's a 50 degree angle that AB makes from the horizontal. So let's start off with drawing a free body diagram, and then I'll show you how to solve it. With our free body diagram, let's imagine that we have a pair of scissors. We're going to cut through all the cables that are supporting A. A is going to be our particle. It's one point in space. So we're going to redraw A over here. So here's our ring A, where everything connects together. Then, where we cut through this cable, we instead put the force that's in the cable. This was a mass of 100 kilograms, and so we need to multiply that by 9.81 so that we can convert it into newtons. So we have this 100 kilograms times 9.81. For FAB, we cut through card AB over here, and so we show the force that was in that cable. We want to label it something like F or T, and then use the two points, so AB, so FAB or TAB. We also want to show that it's a vector, and so we'll go ahead and put the vector symbol on top to show that that's a vector quantity. Over here, we cut through AC, and so we show the force that was in AC, we label it again F or T, and then since it's an AC, FAC, and then again with the arrow on top to show that it's a vector. Because we have the distance information over there, we can draw a similar triangle on this force. So the 4 meters here was parallel to the horizontal, parallel to the x-axis, so the 4 goes down on the bottom. The 3 meters dimension here is parallel to the vertical. It's parallel to the y-axis. And so the 3 goes on this vertical side over here. When you take 3 squared plus 4 squared, and then you take a square root, you get 5. It's 3, 4, 5 right triangle. So we've got that 3, 4, 5 right triangle now sketched in. And that's going to give us the direction information on FAC. Now let's go ahead and set up our sum of forces equations in the x direction, and then we can start solving. Make sure when you're writing these equations that you do write sum of forces in the x equals 0. That helps the grader or the person, the professor, if the professor's grading the test, kind of follow your work here. So we have sum of forces in the x direction is equal to 0, and we have the x component from FAB. So the magnitude of FAB times the cosine of 50 degrees. We're using cosine because the x side is adjacent to that angle. It touches the angle of 50 degrees. Then over here with our similar triangles, we're going to still use the magnitude of FAC, and then we're going to multiply it by a ratio of one of the sides to the hypotenuse. Remember, the hypotenuse is this longer side here of 5. So when we're doing this, since this is going in the x direction, we're going to pick this portion of the similar triangle that goes in the x direction. So we're going to pick that 4 side there. 4 side goes on top and divide by the 5 side, which is our hypotenuse. And let's go through and do the algebra real quick on this one. And just a real quick look, we've got cosine of 50 degrees. Go ahead, put that in your calculator, get a decimal for that. And then you have 4/5 converted to decimals, your 0.8. Over here, both of these two terms are equal to 0. So we're going to add this negative term to both sides. That's going to move this over to the other side of the equation. So we have 0.6428 FAB is now equal to 0.8 FAC. Then we're going to divide both sides of the equation by the 0.6428. And that gives us FAB is 1.245 FAC. Now let's do our sum of forces in the y. So here's our sum of forces in the y equation. We have the y component of FAB, and it's going to be FAB sine of 50 degrees. We're using sine because we're looking at the vertical side here, which is opposite to the angle. And then we have FAC times the vertical side, because we're doing sum of forces in the y, which is going to be the 3 side divided by the hypotenuse, which is the 5 side. Then down here we have a negative 981 newtons, so we do minus 981, and that's all equal to 0. And again, when you're writing either one of these two equations, make sure that you write the sum of forces, give the direction, and say that it's equal to 0. It helps people follow your work. Now let's finish up with the algebra here and get a solution. So just like before, we'll take the sine and just go ahead and put it in your calculator, convert it out, get a decimal. Do the 3/5, convert that over to a decimal. We've got the negative 981 here, so we're going to add 981 to both sides. So it'll send the 981 over to this side of the equation. And then we have this expression, this equation that we already developed from sum of forces in x. We'll go ahead and plug that in. So where we have FAB over here, we're instead going to plug in 1.245 FAC, and so you can see that being plugged in there. And then we'll go ahead and make the multiplication with the coefficients, and then add that coefficient to it. That'll give us 1.554 FAC is equal to 981 newtons, and then divide through both sides here by the 1.554, and we get FAC is equal to 631. We'll take that 631, plug it back in up here, multiply it by the 1.245, and we'll get the 786 newtons there for the FAC. And we're done on this problem. Thanks for watching.